One must never forget the rich heritage of this country. Whatever way one looks at it, India is so vast a treasure house of ancient traditions, customs and tastes that no one can claim to know it entirely. In fact, the diverse and beautiful traditions of this country are still being discovered.
One such discovery was made when Charles Fabry, a noted Hungarian Indologist and art critic, made a chance visit to a cultural event and saw a dance that would later be hailed as one of the most beautiful classical dance forms of India. In 1948, this dance was named Odissi by poet Kali Charan Patnaik. The dance soon gained recognition all over the country and was promoted by pioneering dancers like Sanjukta Panigrahi. Sanjukta's beautiful dancing was accompanied by the voice of her husband, the renowned singer Raghunath Panigrahi, and together they played a key role in the resurrection of Odissi dance form.
Unko to hum kahenge karma yogini thi wo. Aaj agar Odissi kehte hain hamare watan mein तो ओडिसी को तैयारी करने में हाथ पांव जोड़ने का एक टूटा हुआ टॉय को क्या बोलते हैं टॉय को खिलौने को हम लोग जैसे टूटा हुआ उसको बनाते हैं ये भी एक टूटा हुआ कला थी एक समय पर और कौन सा कहां लगेगा किसको मालूम नहीं था जब तक संयुक्ता कुछ शिक्षा प्राप्त करके
The lyrical qualities of Odissi that were embodied in Sanjukta Panigrahi's graceful movements soon made Odissi immensely popular with audiences. Priyamada Mohanty was another early dancer who contributed to the recognition and revival of the dance form, both in and outside of Orissa.
Before I learned from Guru Pankajcharan Das, I actually learned from a series of gurus, including one from the temple itself, Singhari Samsundarkar. Then I learned from Guru Deva Prasad Das, and I came with Guru Deva Prasad Das to the first inter-university youth festival. Actually, in the first inter-university youth festival, I performed Odissi. When it was not known, and after I performed, it was hailed as the discovery of one of the most beautiful classical dance forms. And at that time, I became conscious of the fact that what I was doing is an important form of dance. Until then, I took it as a hobby. I went back and traced its origin, went to Puri, saw the Maharis, got in touch with all the leading gurus, and I'm lucky that I have learned from all the three leading gurus of Odissi. Guru Deva Prasad Das, Guru Kerucharan Mahapatra, and the Guru of Gurus, Guru Sri Pankajcharan Das. The real problem started after my performance because we were challenged to prove that this was a classical dance form. Therefore, we all got together, the gurus, the scholars, the dancers, and put it all together, performed in different places, gave lecture demonstrations to convince people that this was a real classical dance form of India. And it is interesting that it became very, very popular with the audience because of the music, because of the typical sculpturesque qualities, the lyrical qualities. So we never looked back, but in the beginning, for almost 10 years, It was a big struggle and it was not easy to convince that we did have a very, very important dance form with us. Then Odissi dance became accepted very well all over India and in the international scale. And more choreography came in, gurus became very active and they choreographed, expanded on the choreography. That is very important because when I danced in the beginning, it used to be an 8 to 10 minute affair from the beginning till the end. Everything was continuous, Mangalacharan to the end, the moksha, we used to call as Natangi, it used to end in a very, very fast tempo. But in order to make it a performance for the stage and to expand it, we really had to separate it into individual pieces. Mangalacharan in those days, were not enacted. Just use a stand with your hands folded and Ganesh Stuti will be sung, you know, that's it.
As a dance style steeped in antiquity, the forms and poses of Odissi have been chronicled in stone and embellished the walls of the ancient temples of Orissa. The poses in these sculptures form the basis of Odissi and are used extensively in pure dance pieces like Kabattu.
Ah!
The basic postures of Odissi dance mirror the sculptures of the temples of Orissa. Poses like Tribhang, Chok and Abhang are depicted in the Parshurameshwar temple. The Rajarani temple depicts the torso movements typical to Odissi, and the Brahmeshwar temple depicts the Darpani and the Mardala poses. All the temples of Orissa are adorned with sculptures celebrating dance, but none more gloriously than the Sun Temple at Konark.
Pallavi used to be continuous with Abhina. We used to call it Sabhina Pallavi. It had to be in the same raga, flowing into the Abhina. But later on, with the separation and the expansion of these two items, we had started in performing Pallavis, which did not be in the same raga as the Abhinaya.
Certain key elements of the Odissi dance style clearly distinguish it from the other classical dance styles. One important aspect is the pose of the Tribhang, meaning three bends. In this pose, the first bend of the body comes from the crossing of the legs, the second by a curvature of the waist, and the third by an inclination of the head. In pure and decorative items, like Nritta in Odissi, importance is given to Chok, where the feet are separated, making the thighs almost horizontal. Padda Bhedas define the position of the feet. Chari refers to the way a dancer moves. The spinning movements of the dance are called Bhramris.
If postures in Rita are the body of Odissi dance, then Abhinaya is its soul and Hastas its language. Nritya, Abhinaya and Hasta combine together to communicate a dancer's devotion to Lord Jagannath.
Abhinaya mein wahi visheshata hai sattvik bhav ko. Sattvik bhav matlab hai ki man mein wahi dhira. Dhira matlab hai ki dhira bhavna sharir mein ushaita hona chahiye. Aur Krishna kaise dukhi hai, Krishna kaise Vrindavan mein baithe hain, ab sachit mein jao. ये सच मुझे से इसको बोलना पड़ता है, इसको कोई सिखाने की बात नहीं है, गुरुजी के पास सीखना पड़ता है, मगर बोलने के समय में, अभिनय करने के समय में सच वही सखी जैसे अपनी प्रिय राधा को बोलते हैं कि जाओ.
Mudras are a language of hand gestures that are used in abhinay or expressive dance. These hastas have been elaborately described in ancient texts such as Abhinay Darpan by Nandikeshwar and Natya Shastra.
Hasta mudra Odisha mein traditionally bahut mudra bhi tha. Iska baad Natya Shastra, Abhinay Darpan aur Bharat varsh mein Bharat desh mein bahut shastra hai. वो शास्त्र में बहुत भी मुद्रा है. मुद्रा जो ट्रेडिशनल मुद्रा से स्टार्ट हुआ, गुटीप महारी में जो मुद्रा था, वो मुद्रा को लेकर लाइक गुटीप में था प्रदीप. वो प्रदीप भी हम लोग अभी व्यवहार कर रहे हैं. गवाक्ष अभी भी गवाक्ष कर रहे हैं. दौर लाइक दरजा जो कर रहे हैं इसे, मैंने तांबूल लाइक बिटली, मैंने राधा और कृष्ण, ये सब भी पहले बहुत था ट्रेडिशनली.
Thank you. सखी है केशी मथन मोदारम सखी है केशी
Abhinaya has expanded like anything. Initially, they were all, from Gopalakrishna, Baladevarat, Kabishurjya, or Banamali, all Oriya lyrics. Later on, Jayadev's Gita Govinda was incorporated. Because although in the temple, the Mahari sang Gita Govinda was not enacted. And that also enriched the repertoire considerably. Previously, Moksha was just a fast piece of dance at the end, which used to be called as Natangi. But later on, shlokas were introduced and, to get into the mood of Moksha, Prapti and all. And that has become almost an item in itself, a self-sufficient item. So if you consider the first, Odissi as it used to be 8-10 minutes, has expanded to 2-3 hours, in the process.
I often wonder how an ancient dance form like Odissi, with such rich heritage and such deep roots in the cultural life of the people, could remain isolated and undiscovered for so long. Despite the years it took to find recognition, Odissi finally emerged from the shadows with the identity of an art form as pure as the soul. Along my journey, I met some of the greatest artists from the field of Odissi dance. Artists whose talent proved that this great art form, which was once revealed only to the gods, is tangible and accessible even to the mortals.
Mrs. Sumitra Charatram, founder of the Bharatiya Kala Kendra in New Delhi, is among the patrons and benefactors who led the post-independence movement to recognize and support the beautiful arts and talented artists of India.
तभी मुझे मैंने सुना भी नहीं था कि ओडिसी नृत्य होता क्या है. मैंने कहा ओडिसी डांस में किसको बुलाएं. तो उसने इस वक्त इंद्रानी रहमान को जानते थे, उन्होंने कहा कि जो मेरे गुरु हैं उनको बुला लीजिए। तो हमने कहा चलो पहले हम गीत गोविंद करते, पर थोड़ा सा सीख के हमने गीत गोविंद कर लिया। जब गीत गोविंद हमने कर लिया तो उसके बाद हमारी ये इच्छा हुई कि भाई इस शैली को तो आगे बढ़ाएंगे, इसको अपने इंस्टीट्यूशन में चलाएंगे। तो उसके बाद हमने मायाधर जी आए, मायाधर राउत ने बहुत अच्छे स्टूडेंट पैदा किए, उन्होंने अलोका पानीकर को उन्होंने सिखाया और किरण सहगल को सिखाया, कितने लोग हैं अंबिका को सिखाया, काफ़ी सारे स्टूडेंट किए। मंदिरों वगैरह की जो मूर्ति हैं उनको देखने का मुझे बहुत शौक था, हमेशा इसे मैंने देखा और मुझे उनकी पोजेज वगैरह देख के बहुत अच्छी लगती थी। तो मैंने कहा कि जब इंसान ये तो मूर्ति हैं पत्थर की, वो उनमें भी ऐसा लगता है कि भाव आता है तो इंसान में भी आ सकता है। तो मुझे ओडिसी डांस में ये लगा कि ओडिसी डांस ही है जो कि ये भावना को प्रकट कर सकता है।
While teaching at the भारतीय कला केंद्र, गुरु मायाधर राउत gained recognition for his significant contributions to the अभिनय of Odissi by introducing संचारी भाव to the Ashtapadis of Jayadev and to various Odia songs. Another guru who has made Delhi his home, Guru Trinath Maharana, is trained in the Gotipua style and is also proficient in playing the pakhavaj. Once a teacher at Gandharva Mahavidyalaya, he has now established his own school of Odissi.
उड़ीसी डांस का कोई भी क्लासिकल डांस का भविष्य वो स्टूडेंट का ऊपर ही डिपेंड करता है। जैसे अच्छी तरह सिखा ले और 10 स्टूडेंट को वो सिखाएं अच्छी तरह तो वो भविष्य अच्छा बन जाता है।
श्री दुर्गा चरण रणबीर हैज एस्टैब्लिश्ड हिमसेल्फ एज द मोस्ट प्रोमिनेंट रिप्रेजेंटेटिव ऑफ हिज गुरु द लेट देवा प्रसाद दास। He has successfully enriched Odissi with many of his own choreographies, but at the same time, he has preserved the repertoire that he inherited from his guru.
Odissi dance पहले मंदिर में कि गोटीपुए में एक डांस एक दो डांसर गोटीपुए में दो डांस की एक लड़का डांस किया था। मंदिर में महारी एक महारी डांस किया था। अभी क्या ग्रुप डांस चार पांच से हाथ ऐसे खंड देंगे ऐसे ये कर देंगे और ग्रुप डांस होगा, ये तो कमर्शियल सरकार करता है।
The controversy over solo versus group dance goes on and both types continue to be performed. Jyoti Srivastav is presently among Guru Ranbir's senior disciples. Krishna Behra was among those who pioneered the movement that brought Odissi dance out of Orissa. By making a permanent move to Delhi, he has introduced the art to a new set of audiences and students, including his own daughter, Kavita Dwivedi.
Rutu Rajana पंचम स्वर रे परावृत कले पंचम स्वर रे
When I came from Bombay to here 32 years ago and I remember Yamini Sonal later on Madhavi etc performed for the tourist near Connaught Place and it was Indrani Rahman who's to organize this it's Charles Fabry who's responsible for bringing into focus Odissi was not accepted as a classical dance until quite late you see whether something is accepted or not it remains its quality and energy remains but the real people initially in modern India people who are responsible Minati Mishra Priyambada Mahanti Indrani who unfortunately passed away recently Charles Fabry Dhiren Patnaik in Orissa and then of course there are now hundreds of exponents of Odissi dance
Sonal Mansingh is widely known for her prolific performing career a known name in the Bharatanatyam world she is also a highly acclaimed Odissi dancer Kiran Sehgal and Madhavi Mudgal both hail from artistic family backgrounds and are now both well established in their own right as performers and teachers of Odissi. Kumkum Mohanty is one of the distinguished senior dancers of Odissi. As the director of the Odissi Research Center in Bhubaneswar, she has dedicated her time and energy to refining and promoting the young artists of tomorrow. Ramesh Chandra Jaina and Madhusmita Mohanty are among the young rising stars of the Odissi dance scene. The dance of this dynamic pair speaks promisingly for the future of the art.
Oh, as a journalist and a critic, I have seen a lot of changes coming over this style, as over the world of dance in general. In the early 70s and 80s, it was the crystallization of the various sub-styles which had led to many dancers and gurus to perfect those sub-styles.
Sub-styles have been beneficial in providing a wider scope to Odissi dancers. Anita Babu is trained in the style of Guru Gangadhar Pradhan. Sharon Lowen came from the United States to India on a Fulbright scholarship to study the classical dance form of Manipuri, but ended up becoming a star in Odissi instead. A disciple of Guru Kelucharun Mohapatra, she has imbibed the spirit of Odissi and is now a serious exponent of the form.
Odissi dance is about love, truth, and beauty. I've had the opportunity in my life to learn classical Western ballet, modern dance, coming to India to continue Manipuri, which is an elegant and subtle style, to learn chal, which has the strength and demanded the training that I already had with 17 years of modern dance. But when I started learning Odissi, I found a form that enabled me to have not only beautiful lyrical movement, wonderful rhythmic combinations, but above all, the opportunity to explore the depth of human emotion, the inner self that we all share. Malina vasani saumya nikshipya veena mad gotrank virachita padam geyam udgatu kama tan Nayana salile saraitva kathanchi bhuyo bhuya bhuyo bhuya swayamapitita murchana
Sani da ba ga ni sa.
Iliana Citaresti, an Italian by birth, is another dancer who was so inspired by the beauty of Odissi that she made Orissa her home and dedicated her life to the dance.
I think the Odissi repertoire has stabilized a great deal, and what is more exciting is that we've started seeing experimentation. Today you find people stepping out of that and experimenting with newer songs, newer choreography. You know, this controversy between solo and group is ongoing in all forms of art, in practically all forms of art. Well, perhaps Kathakali is one form which we accept as group performances. But I think that the spirit of Odissi does not change with group performances.
The circuit gets completed only when a dancer, the rasika, the critic, the viewer, the onlooker, the listener are together.
Guru Yadunandani Chandana Shishir Guru Yadunandani Chandana Shishir Tarin Karin Payodhar
A dancer himself, Jeevan Pani was one of the greatest scholars on Odissi dance. His recent death has sadly left us only with his writing to remember him by. The death of Pratima Bedi is another great loss for Odissi. This beautiful dancer is known for founding the Nrityagram dance village outside Bangalore.
Odissi touches you in a way that it transforms you and your life forever. You no longer dance because your body is restless or your spirit sways to the rhythm. Instead, you live dance. It is as if the world of emotion and passion is revealed in your eyes, and you are far removed from the trivial pain and pleasure of mortality. There is nothing but dance, nothing but joy. Just as I thought my journey for the discovery of Odissi dance had come to an end, I realized my Odissi had just begun.